Hey everybody, so today we are going to be talking about what is a taxonomy really? And the reason I put it that way is I think there's a lot of confusion and angst when it comes to the labeling of what this exactly is. So here are some words that you might have heard: controlled vocabulary, ontology, taxonomy, subject headings, thesauri, feature lists, topical lists. These, yes, all have some differences between them, but the takeaway is taxonomies are often used as a way of describing many different aspects of these things. If you are interested in how these distinctions all play out, there you go. I also have a whole video right there talking about the differences. But suffice it to say, a taxonomy is a way to organize things. All variations of controlled lists of topical, geographic, people, companies that are assigned to content, to assets, in order to make them more discoverable. Okay, it is something that usually has a broader and narrower kind of relationship. But you will also usually find see also, which is things that are very often related to that topic, as well as use for, which are synonyms or alternate labels or alternate forms of describing that said thing. Taxonomies usually have labels, should have UIDs, and hopefully some kind of context for each of those topics, but unfortunately that's not always common. Why are they useful? So you will often see these in two forms. The first is a front end kind of application, which are usually browse taxonomies or categories. And you see these often in product, like here, as well as rolling up categories so that you can find things in a quick fashion, like here. So that is usually how you see them represented on the screen. Now there are other forms of this, but for now, those are the most common. Now you can also see this behind the scenes. So how would you recognize this on the screen if it's used on the back end? Well, recommendation engines, like here, that's how you would know a taxonomy is being used. It's looking at what are the different types of things that are often related with whatever you're looking for in a search engine, as well as things that are very commonly associated with that thing. So here, I search for cat bowl. What do you usually use with a cat bowl? Well, maybe you also need a mat for under the bowl. Maybe you need to put stuff inside the bowl. These are different kinds of things that might be often related to a taxonomy. Now, you can up your game with a knowledge graph associated with this, but that's for another video. On the back end, you might also be using a taxonomy to help you with your machine learning. So if I put Jupyter into a search engine, would it know what I meant? Do you know what I mean? Well, maybe if I add some context, it would understand what I'm talking about. But when machine learning is being conducted, context is really important. So if you are trying to teach a machine the difference between this Jupyter and this Jupyter, you might have to give it some additional context. Hierarchies give context. Now, when you are looking at a hierarchy, there are three different ways that you can look at a broader, narrower kind of relationship. The first is when the children of a topic are different types. They are more specific instances of that thing. So if we are looking at cat, there are different types of cat. Different types, more specific types. What you also might see is what would be considered a part of relationship. So electric vehicle, and then the children are different parts for an electric vehicle. Now you might ask, well, which one is correct? They're both correct. So if you were trying to help people drill into what kind of cat memorabilia they were looking for, well, if you really need to get the cat breed correct, then having types of cats in your children under cat would be helpful. Whereas if you are an auto mechanic and you need to understand all the different parts associated with a specific model of electric vehicle, having different types of parts in your child relationships might actually make more sense. Now, there is a third category, and that is when these two types are mixed and matched. You'll see this the most in legacy taxonomies that have lived for a long time, and maybe they're not being maintained like they used to be. That's not really best practice, but just be aware you might see it, and this is what it might look like. Honorable mentions, Bloom's taxonomy, which is something used in the teaching realm. There is also the taxonomic animal kingdom kind of taxonomy that also a lot of people are familiar with. But if you look at all of those examples, they are taking types of things, they are putting a label on those things, and they are putting them into a broader and narrower kind of relationship. Okay, so let's look at what does a taxonomy look like on a browse kind of interface. Well, Amazon is a really good example where they drill you into the different categories and then there are subcategories that you can select from. Something else that is very useful in maybe Spotify or Netflix is how they group all the different types of genres that mean action movie into a broader level action movie so that you can just look to your heart's desire, or you can search for more specific ones if you go into their search engine. So that's the nice thing about taxonomies is you can pick and choose how each level of the taxonomy is being used, whether it's on a browse function or in the back end. This is something that you actually use every day and you might not realize it. So have you ever noticed when you go to the grocery store that most of your main necessity staples are on the peripheral of the grocery store? In fact, there's a lot of advice that says if you shop on the peripheral of the grocery store, you will be a little bit healthier. But the reason that you go to the produce section and anything there is considered produce and all the lettuces are in one area together and all of the tomatoes and all of the potatoes are in specific locations is because that is how people think about information. This guy kind of did some of that very early on, and that's what a lot of librarians take their cue from. Is this categorical data. I'm looking for produce, that's one level. I am now looking in the produce section, right? Now I've limited the scope of my grocery store. Now I'm looking at different types of potatoes. It's another level, okay? Well, I don't really want an Idaho potato because I'm not making French fries, I am making buttered potatoes. So I need red russet potatoes that are really tender. Okay, that's another type. And maybe there is another subtype, which is one is organic and one is not. Maybe I eat organic, that's another layer. Well, what do you know? I think I just made a little taxonomy. See, it's everywhere. Now, where is your favorite place to get coffee? If you look at their menu, you'll notice there is an area for coffee. Now I'm at my local coffee joint and I have limited, I'm looking for coffee and not tea. Maybe there's hot coffee and cold coffee, especially if you're in New England and you like your cold coffees. Cold brews are big. So now I've limited to, I want some hot coffee. Now you can see, oh, there's different types of hot coffee. Maybe there's different types of beans, there's different additives. All of this adds up to a taxonomy and you're using it every day. Well, what about organizing your bills? Maybe you have all the car payments or the mortgage payments in different locations. Maybe you have all of your medical information in a different location in your filing cabinet or wherever you're storing your bills. It's kind of hierarchy, right? It's kind of taxonomy. Maybe you are looking at your DVD collection. Maybe you have them segmented by DVD versus Blu-ray. Or maybe you don't have anything that's physical anymore and you have to organize them in your local streaming service. How would you do that? You would think about it from maybe a genre perspective, or maybe you're a diehard Schwarzenegger fan. So you have all your Schwarzenegger movies in one location and you can go and find them. These are all organizational methods that are using a hierarchy, i.e. a taxonomy. All right, so I hope that was helpful. I hope this has maybe opened your eyes to see where taxonomy is in your everyday life, because it has a lot of implications, because this is a normal, everyday way that people organize information around them. So what this means is a lot of us are using taxonomies and we don't realize it. And for those of you that are taxonomists, good job, because you make the world go round and you bring order to chaos. Okay, so with that, I want to thank you very much, and I'll catch you next time.